ZIPP's new 3ZERO Moto carbon wheel sets are inspired by motocross to provide riders with the control and durability required for pure speed. Our single wall approach, what we call Moto technology, allows the rims to pivot from either side of the spoke bed while traversing rough terrain. This approach translates to a unique wheel and a unique build. As you know, ZIPP's 3ZERO Moto wheels are available as complete wheel sets, but you can also purchase rims only and build them with your choice of hubs. I'm Nick James, Master Wheel Builder at ZIPP, and this video is going to walk you through some of the distinctive steps of building these rims. Please note, this is not a step-by-step video, but rather a guide for an experienced builder to understand the nuances of constructing your own set of 3ZERO Moto wheels. We'll start by talking about the parts needed, then the do's and the don'ts, and why this will make building 3ZERO Moto wheels way more satisfying. ZIPP recommends using a nipple with a length of 14 millimeters or longer. Use a nipple with a shallow head, either round or hex. If you're using a non-locking nipple, it is a good practice to add spoke prep prior to the building. This will keep the nipple from backing off during the build. All 3ZERO Moto rims will come with the washers necessary for this build. You must use the supplied washers for your build as they are specifically sized to work with the 3ZERO Moto rim. Not using the supplied washers can cause damage to the rim and will void the warranty. For building 3ZERO Moto rims, we recommend using double-butted spokes with the dimensions of 2.0, 1.65 to 2.0, or 2.0, 1.8 to 2.0. If you prefer, you can use straight gauge spokes in either 1.8 or 2.0. When calculating your spoke dimensions, always err on the side of longer to ensure you achieve full thread engagement, as we will discuss later. It is important that you only lace your 3ZERO Moto rims in a 3-cross pattern on both sides of the rim. We do not support building any 3ZERO Moto rims into radial 1 or 2 cross lacing patterns. This would result in less than optimal performance, which could cause injury to the rider and void the warranty. 3ZERO Moto rims are designed as an asymmetric rim, where the same rim can be used for the front or rear wheel. The rim has a short and a long side defined by the distance from the spoke holes. When I build a 3ZERO Moto wheel, I always start with the short side of the rim facing up. For the rear wheel, the short side of the rim will align with the non-drive side of the hub. For the front wheel, the short side of the rim will always be on the drive side. Let's discuss bringing the wheel up to tension. First thing you may notice is the spokes will seem long due to the single wall design of the rim. This allows for full thread engagement. To bring up the tension evenly, I recommend making fewer turns per nipple than you may typically make on a double wall rim. This will help keep the 3ZERO Moto rim straighter and provide a stronger build. When bringing the wheel up to final tension, we want to aim for 115 kgf with room for plus or minus 10 kgf. When building a 3ZERO Moto rim, you will want to pre-stress the wheel during the build like you would any other wheel. However, you will want to wait until you achieve a higher tension, somewhere around the 100 kgf mark. Before performing this important step, this is due to the compliance provided by the Moto technology. Once you have reached 100 kgf, perform a hand pre-stress by squeezing the spokes while the wheel is in the truing stand. Once complete, continue tensioning the wheel to the full amount of 115 kgf. At this time, you can remove the wheel from the stand and place it on the table or the floor and apply your typical pre-stressing techniques, making sure to flip the wheel and stress both sides. Because the 3ZERO Moto is a single wall rim, you can see the exposed nipple head throughout the build. This allows for a useful gauge to confirm you properly sized your spokes. Our goal is to achieve full nipple thread engagement with the spoke. The spoke should be within a half millimeter of being flush to the end of the nipple or no more than 1.5 millimeters of the exposed spoke. Like every rim, the 3ZERO Moto rim has a tooling seam. For strength and integrity, we do not sand down or finish this seam. If you're using a radial runout gauge on your truing stand, you may get a reading showing a small jump at this seam. That is okay. Our recommendation is if you have a small jump at the seam between the adjacent spokes, do your best to minimize, but it may not be possible to eliminate. Due to the single wall design of the 3ZERO Moto rims, they do require the use of both a rim strip and a tubeless rim tape. Once the wheel is finished, you will first need to install the rim strip. It is important to note that the rim strip has two sides, a smooth side and a textured side. You must install the rim strip with the smooth side out to provide adequate adhesion of the tubeless rim tape. Make sure that the rim strip is well aligned to the rim and covering all the nipple heads. Again, the rim strip is required on all 3ZERO Moto rims and serves two purposes. One, it keeps the nipples in place. Two, it prevents the nipples from poking through the tubeless rim tape. To install the tubeless rim tape, clean the rim and install the rim tape with two full wraps. Thanks for joining us for this video guide. Enjoy your 3ZERO Moto wheels and enjoy a great day on the trails.